You've got Franco Boffi of Italy, who we're told by the Italians will sacrifice himself for Panetta. That's Franco Boffi, 5-8-1. So he may make the early pace, but will the Kenyans, who've also got through, three through, let them? 6-6-0, Peter Koech. 5-9-2, Lambruschini, the other Italian. There's Brian Dima, the Olympic bronze medalist, America. Regalo of Portugal. Panier of France. Panetta, the Italian number one. Ilg, the defending world champion, coming back to form from West Germany. Graham Fell, the Canadian now, born in Britain, a member of Essex Beagles, now emigrated. Henry Marsh, the top American. Van Dijk of Belgium. 6-5-4, Kip Kemboi, Kenya. Roger Hackney of Great Britain. The European champion, 4-7-4, Melzer, East Germany. And on the outside, the third Kenyan, Patrick Sang. 15 in this final, and we're looking for something special. The Italians want to make it fast for Panetta. Will the Kenyans let them? The final of the World Championship, 3,000 metres, and Boffi's trying to dictate it, but he's not allowed to, by Peter Koech, the Kenyan. And the Kenyans undoubtedly will mess the Italians about. They're first at the moment and last. Koech leads. Boffi tried to take the lead, and Boffi's now taking it. Lambruschini's up there, and Panetta is following Boffi. So clearly, the Italian plan we heard about is there to be seen. Boffi takes it. Panetta in second place. Koech is third. Looking back through the field, Roger Hackney started fairly quickly, but they've all had to start quickly, because it's going to be a battle from gun to the finish. Coming to the water for the first time. Melzer, 4-7-4, the European champion, well in touch. But Boffi's really streaking along, and the Kenyans are not going to let them dictate the pace. They're going to mess them about, there's no question about that. And I would think the Kenyan plan will be not to let the Italians run an even pace and settle down.
Evangelisti, the other Italian, on duty at the far side, and he's had a good jump too. Evangelisti is in sixth place at the moment with 8 metres and nine. And look at this crowd. They've got Italians all over the track and Italians in the long jump pit. And they appreciate that. And let's wait to see what is happening in terms of the distance. Evangelisti is celebrating. Remember, he is an 8-metre 40 jumper. Now, how far has he gone? And is he in medal contention? He really went hard for the board and got a lift that takes him out to 8 metres and 19, and it puts him into bronze medal position. But look how close he was to a no jump.
Well, the Italian crowd going mad, moved into medals in the long jump, and they're hoping for medals here in the steeplechase and hoping for gold. Kenya in front, and the Kenyans, Brendan Foster, seem to me to be determined not to allow the Italians to dictate the race.
But that's what I love about distance running, because you've got the Europeans calculating in their training and calculating in their tactics. They've got a plan hatched last night, and Panetta, to help Panetta run the sting out of the fast finishers. And then you've got the Kenyans, who don't care about what tactics, they're just going to get in the race, they're going to run, and if they feel good, they're going to challenge, and they don't care about anybody else's ideas. But the pace is tremendous. They're running about, my calculations, David, they're running about 8 minute pace for 3,000 metres. The world record is 8.5, so this race is going to be a great one.
Actually, oddly enough, although it doesn't appear to be so from the human eye, they slowed down on the second lap, but in fact they're on 8.12 pace, just outside of world record schedule. Well, Panetta's now taking it of himself. Kip Kemboi there goes alongside him, and every time an Italian takes the front, Kip Kemboi is the Kenyan who gets there and upsets him and ruffles him. Panetta leading into the water jump. Kip Kemboi in second place. Regalo, Portugal, third. Melzer, East Germany, four. But it's quite significant that as soon as an Italian hits the front, a Kenyan, and it's usually Kip Kemboi, follows him. The other two Kenyans have dropped back down the field. Panetta leads, Kip Kemboi in second place. Third is Regalo of Portugal. In fourth place, Melzer of East Germany. Fifth is Panier of France. Sixth is Van Dijk. Seventh, another Kenyan's moving through. And in eighth place, the world champion, Ilg.
Well, Panetta decided he was going to lead after 1,000 metres. He knows exactly what he's got to do, but he's got tremendous support in this stadium. The crowd are going mad supporting him, but he's got the Africans to deal with. And don't forget the other Europeans. You've got Meltzer, the European champion. You've got Van Dijk, and Kip Kemboi fell there. So that tactic is now beginning to trouble the other Kenyans. They're starting to move up through the race, and Panetta's got a gap. This is exactly what he wanted to have.
So, by varying the pace and losing his stride pattern, Kip Kemboi has paid for it. You've got to get the stride pattern right to hit the hurdle on the right foot. You've got to be the hurdle on both feet, in fact, off both feet. But he got it totally wrong then. Missed out on the stride, trying to fix it up, and Kip Kemboi walks away dejected. Well, Panetta is now left absolutely clear, and the Italian crowd going berserk as he comes round with three laps to go. Van Dijk of Belgium second, Meltzer of East Germany third, Tanier of France in fourth place. Then comes Peter Koech of Kenya, followed by Regalo, followed by Graham Fell, followed by Sang of Kenya, Dima, America. And Roger Hackney at the moment is back in 15th place.
Well, Panetta there, I think, was lifted by the fact that he saw a gap growing behind him, and he's determined to drive on for the finish. You know, his nickname is Turbo Diesel, and you can understand why. He's running like an engine here, but the race is being led behind him by Van Dijk, who's the fastest man in the world this year. He'll cover the gap slowly. He'll gradually come back. Van Dijk's got a tremendous finish, and I noticed Meltzer in third place is hanging in there. We saw this kind of race in the European Championships last year, and remember, Panetta died in the European Championships. He's a stronger athlete now, and he's got the home support, and I can guarantee you that he won't fail here through lack of bravery.
Panetta, the silver medalist in the 10,000 metres, silver medalist in the European Championship, when he led all the way. Has now got two laps to go and a very good lead indeed. He's got about 20 metres from Van Dijk. Meltzer in third place. Peter Koech is fourth. Graham Fell of Canada in fifth place. Dima, America, sixth. Sang, Kenya, seven. Panier is in eighth place. Henry Marsh beginning to improve, but as usual, very, very late. And Panetta just stuttered into the hurdle, but he found the right stride. Van Dijk in second place, closing slightly. Meltzer, the European champion, is third. And Ilg, the West German holder of the world title, next to last. So we're going to have a new champion. Panetta, the battler, out in front. Van Dijk closing very slightly. But it's still a good lead. And already the crowd celebrating with just over a lap to go. Panetta looks strong. He's not the best technician in this field, but he's certainly the strongest man. There's the bell. Again, stutters into the hurdle. Van Dijk all fluent in second place. Meltzer's third, and they're battling on. It's Koech four, Dima five, Fell six, Marsh seven, Sang eight. And Van Dijk is closing now all the time. And Meltzer's a fast finisher too. Panetta's now got about, around 15 metres. And he's hanging on. He's got three jumps left. That's one of them. And he's beginning to climb them now. Van Dijk is still closing, but it's very, very slowly. The water jump of one barrier left. Panetta, an anxious glance. Oh, he jumped the hurdle there. He hurdled the barrier. He didn't take a chance. And he's now in front by some 12 metres. And going away again. Panetta could get gold for Italy. He's got it right. Meltzer comes second. Van Dijk is third. And the celebrations have started. On the track and around the arena. Panetta wins the world title. Meltzer, the European champion, second. Van Dijk is third. Dima four, Graham Fell in fifth place, Marsh is sixth, Koech seven, Sang in eighth place, Lavrashini is nine, Panier 10, Regalo 11. Il, the defending world champion, is number 12. Franco Boffi in 13th place, and Roger Hackney is in 14th place for Great Britain. A tremendous run, 8 minutes, 8.58, the fourth fastest time in history. And he's done it on World Championship Day and done it in front of his home crowd. Roger Hackney coming home, he's not enjoyed the heat, he struggled to qualify, and he's found it very hard. But he made the final, as he did 4 years ago. That's Gabriele Dorio, the Italian middle distance runner, the Olympic champion at 1500 metres, celebrating with Panetta. And they're going to enjoy this, not just this afternoon, but all night and all this week and probably all the year. They came here for this, the stadium packed, and they got what they paid for. Gabriele Dorio with Alberto Covo, one of Panetta's training companions, the man, in fact, who won the World, European and Olympic 10,000 metres. But the truth is, in training, Panetta absolutely broke him down, which is why Covo has not been able to run here. This, one of the strong men of international athletics. Second in the 10,000 metres on the opening night, and now gold in the steeplechase. Well, the celebration started as Panetta took the last barrier. He celebrated, and the crowd joined in all the way down the straight. And what an occasion this is. Italian chief coach in the background. But the whole of Italy will join in this one. They really have produced, in recent years, some tremendous distance athletes. Don't forget, they were first, second and third in the European 10,000 metre championship last year. And this is the way he did it, coming into the last barrier. He just made absolutely sure of that, climbed it a bit, looked back. And, well, all the tension had gone, released from all that, and still ran the fourth fastest time in the world. He's looking for the crowd to enjoy this moment, and they certainly joined him.
Well, David, I think distance runners in the world will rejoice, not only the Italians, but to see somebody go out, look at the aggression on his face there, but to see someone to go out and execute their plan. He doesn't care about the fastest time in the world, winning in Rome the World Championship, celebrating it in true style.
Said the other day when he qualified, he looks a bit like a boxer. He's got the bill, probably very, very strong with welterweight. He doesn't half show. He really is one of the power men in sport, in this sport. And as you watch him come home, that nickname, Brendan, well, he's well named, isn't it? What is it?
Well, it's turbo diesel, and we can understand now why now, because he's not very good over those jumps. He's a bit better than Kim Kemboy there, who caught it totally unaffected by anyone else. He caught the hurdle and collapsed in a heap on the track. And I think at that point, Panetta took heart from that situation, had a gap, and just started pressing the pace and pulling away. I presume that's his girlfriend.
Well, everybody's joining in. 592 is Lambruschini. Actually, I think Stan Greenberg just pointed out to me, and Alberto Covo, Stan Greenberg just pointed out to me, he would have broken the European record if he hadn't stopped to wave to the crowd. But really, that is not what matters today. What mattered to him and to the whole of Italy was that they got a gold medal in these track and field championships. They've won the walk, but it's one on the track they wanted, and they've got it. There's Alberto Covo, World, or former world now, European and Olympic 10,000 metre champion, his training companion. But it was a tremendous run, and when you look back at what he did in the European Championship, he probably deserved the gold last year in that European, because he made the race right from the start and got beaten for speed off the last hurdle by Meltzer. But Meltzer couldn't get him today and had to settle for second place.
But on the last, you know, on the last lap, David, his technique was a bit rugged. He was determined to just keep going. He was climbing those barriers, and the whole world of distance running will rejoice to see a real runner's runner winning that gold medal.